I just thought that game three, it was a total domination by the Rangers in the second period.
Zucker involved with the Toronto, and they're both going off.
Teams 77, two minutes, unsportsmanlike, Pittsburgh penalty, number 18, 2 minutes,
unsportsmanlike conduct.
For both, they're trying to keep this under control. Left side of your screen, there's Zucker with the first push. Toronto pushes back, and then Zucker with the trip.
Four-on-four hockey.
To get a two-goal cushion. Too many men, or an interference on Gallagher right in front of the Oiler bench.
That's going to be a penalty on him.
And he chops the stick out of Derek Ryan's hands. And that's what he does. He's just trying to open up some space. And watch this. Oh, it's actually off the bench. I thought it was Derek Ryan's stick. It was Derek Ryan that picked it up. He slapped it away. But it was off the bench of the Oilers, and I think he's arguing, listen, you can't have your stick over the boards like that onto the play. I kind of agree with Brendan Gallagher here. You're going to have your stick over the boards on the ice. I mean, it's in play. Get it out of there.
And Wilson has not played since those first few shifts. Marchman, oh, it takes a hard slash. Oh, they're going to send them both off. Marchman and Mantha were going at it. Panther bench, you know, wanted only one call.
Well, Mantha, get it. He got in.
Florida penalty number 17. 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike. Washington penalty number 3. 2 minutes for slashing.
Yeah. Mantha, he gets in the extra slash, that's for sure. They're right off the draw, a little trying to jockey for position. And then there's the slash. It actually breaks the stick of Marchman.
I'm not sure about Marchman's unsportsmanlike. The slash was clear. We go 4-on-4 for the first time tonight.
Let's check in with Dave. What was going on?
There's
there,
an awful lot going on here, Sam, between, I think, two Massachusetts boys here. Watch, Rooney and Vetrano are going to collide right there in the middle of the ice. Now, stay with it. Stay with it, Larry. They got a good job. Now, watch. Goes into the boards, and down goes Vetrano. Looks around, Rooney goes, Prankey, what the beep was that? And it did turn up the heat, boys. Oh, man, there's a lot going on down here.
And Toronto helped it out a little bit. And Florida has the last 7 shots on goal in this game. Shots were 8-4 at one point. They're now 11-8-4.
Oh, Pezzetta just took one on the view. We talked about his ability to draw penalties. Here it is. Now, it's so frustrating because he engages you just to the point where he won't get one, and then you retaliate a little bit, and now he's suckered you in to a penalty that you can't take. You understand what Michael Pezzetta is trying to do. He gave Hoffman a whack on the way to the bench. He wants to get back after him, but you're losing a game in the third period. Your penalty kill has struggled mightily this year.
Montreal, number 55, 2 minute minus for cross-checking.
That's a bit of a bailout to me, because Pezzetta was getting after him pretty quickly. There's one. Yeah, he goes down early, but like, to me, like, there's one guy who's in the penalty there and not both. And Glenn Lew is not a guy
so,
that.
So is that reputation?
I mean,
here you go, right?
Absolutely.
The winner of that one would advance to Wednesday night, Eastern Conference Final. Winner of this series will have home ice. And here's a penalty coming as Kotkaniemi went down. And now they come after D'Angelo. Trouba after D'Angelo after the play.
Now they got to be careful here. D'Angelo's going to get a penalty. Trouba might as well. Trouba's just trying to stir the, D'Angelo's trying to stir the pot as he went in and flipped the puck at Shesterkin. And while you might not be thrilled with that effort by D'Angelo, you can't take an extra penalty. As it is,
New York penalty,
79, 2 minutes tripping. Carolina penalty, 77, 2 minutes unsportsmanlike conduct.
So it's an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty for flipping the puck at the goaltender after the whistle. There's the tripping call on Keandre Miller in the middle of the ice. Here's the unsportsmanlike penalty long after the window by D'Angelo. They congregate, and it'll be 4-on-4 again.
It's the third goalie to give up, and meanwhile, back at the other end of the ice, there's a pileup. Corey Perry with a helmet off.
It's JT Compher.
JT Compher there for the Avalanche.
Oh, look at Perry. He's leaning on his leg.
And the great tradition of hockey will continue.
Trying to cycle the puck. There's a fourth line. Compher and Perry are wrestling around in the net, and as the wrestling match ensues, the whistle blows. So both, at least Perry will end up in the penalty box, and at the tail end of the deal, as Perry's getting up, he leans on the leg of Compher as kind of a parting gift.
They would like him to get back to his goal scoring ways, point as well. Here comes point backhander save by Bobrovsky, who has been razor sharp as well. Both these goaltenders have their games tonight. There's some behind the net stuff. We thought we'd see maybe a little more of this, but this rivalry with some new participants, it's early, some veterans, and then they want to waste too much, but someone's going to go here. You see, it looks like only one, and we're seeing that more this year, Ray, where one player goes to the box out of these scrums.
That's the end of the scrum. As soon as they haul one guy out, nobody wants to be the next guy in the next scrum. Talk to Dave Jackson. Jax, I always started to get nervous when those things are going on and you guys just pulled one guy out.
Well, in this case, I think I saw him signal. It's for grabbing the face mask. It's unsportsmanlike conduct.
Florida penalty number 62, 2 minutes roughing. Tampa Bay penalty number 38, 2 minutes unsportsmanlike conduct, grabbing the visor.
Ah, so they get them both.
Yeah, good call, Jax.
Yep.
The visor grab is one, and the ref was the other. Now Hagel and Montour will beak back and forth. And got the there it is right there. Yeah. As he's got the
they both
the mask.
Had a, yeah, they both had a handful.
So we'll go to 4-on-4 and come. That plays at the end of a really nice Braden Point dash. Maybe his most slick moment of the game.
Takes it to the end boards, back up top to Mello. Logan Stanley, he'll play that ricochet. Jets are on it. Centering pass, and Connor from a spot where he likes to be. Shot it wide, and that one will be absorbed by Samsonov. Shifley and Simmons ready to go.
I think here's your call that's going to give the Jets their power play back. There's a lot of talk. The non-calls, as the studio was talking about Simmons, though, that's
number 24, 2 minutes unsportsmanlike.
He takes the play. How about this block here by Shifley? Where's get him? All right in the top of the foot, and you can see the anguish in his face. He ends up with the puck at the other end, makes a nice pass. Another guy who's just can't quite find the back of the net right now is Connor. And then there's after the end of the play, that little shot. And the reaction was immediate. So this is one for the Winnipeg Jets. You got to find a way. The Maple Leafs got their opportunity.
Cole with a hit on the near wall along with Semgus Girgensons after Asplund made that burst down the left side. Nice keep in by Fitzgerald for a moment there at the far point, and then Tampa going offside of the Buffalo line.
Oh, there's been a penalty assessed to Paparoon. He shot the puck back towards the linesman, and he gave him a misconduct.
Number 14, unsportsmanlike conduct.
Yep. And here's Aspen coming down just before that. He takes a shot, misses the net on the right side there at Elliott, but a good break there, good opportunity coming down with speed. You see him going back to the net. Bench there, taking a look at it, but Sabres going back to the power play here because of a really dumb penalty by Patrick Maroon. Sabres got a chance here to crawl back into this one, tie this one up. And Pat Maroon's been going at the linesman and referee all night. And look at this. He wasn't happy with it. He fires the puck back at the linesman. He tees him up right there, and he's bye-bye, goes bench. Feel shame. And he is looking crazy over there right now because that's not a good penalty to take at this point for a veteran hockey player like Patrick Maroon.
And again, Hornquist out in front. Thornton holds. Now Hornquist puts it in front. The chance, and Dell the save on Verhaeghe.
Well, the Panthers working
and
on
Hornquist
that far side.
Down, Randy.
Yeah. I think that the officials will be a little tentative calling that. They should, though.
Okozo. Well, after the whistle, Hornquist wants a piece of Okozo. Look at this.
Now Okozo drops his gloves. Now the officials are going to be forced to make some calls here. Now they're both of them are going to go.
Well, I don't know why Hornquist would go. I mean, he got knocked down. He never dropped his gloves. But he will go. You're accurate. Both of them unsportsmanlike.
Buffalo penalty, 21, 2 minutes unsportsmanlike conduct. Florida penalty, number 70, 2 minutes unsportsmanlike conduct.
Okay, unsportsmanlike. Let's take a look at the chance here. The Panthers full control on the far side. Look at the puck movement. Hornquist to Verhaeghe. Didn't get a lot of that, and he just drilled it right into the crest of Aaron Dell. And then this is what happened. Okozo comes over and just knocks down. And it, you know, the NHL, they're trying to crack down on these type of infractions when unprovoked acts like that, but two each, the Panthers still on the power play here. Lots of time, 106 in the second.
Okozo is just angry. I'm not sure if Hornquist said something. Now that top power play unit is on.